They say हर घर कुछ कहता है. And if my walls could speak, they would tell you a lot of stories about shared warmth, laughter, craziness, about acceptance, about success, about failures. Yeah, my walls would speak. Hi, I'm Mini Mathur.
I'm Kabir Khan. And welcome to our home. You're watching Asian Paints, where the heart is. You're watching Asian Paints, where the heart is.
What you enter into is my living room. I don't call it the hall, which is the Bombay version of a living room, but I like to call it a living room because that's where everybody lives. As you can see, there's like a whole lot of color. It's something I'm pretty obsessed with. I think all spaces must have a color that reflect how you're feeling at this point of time. All the edges of my house are round. And of course, one goes to Greece and Santorini. I'm very inspired by their architecture and this whole cycladic thing. As far as the room is concerned, as you can see, it's like this. We don't follow a theme. There is no sort of drama around what we're trying to create. It's a little bit of us everywhere. So there's like this 85-year-old table from Hyderabad, from Kabir's ancestral house. Kabir and I like everything that looks weathered, old. Even if we've bought it new, it can't be like spanking shiny new. Even my sofas, when I bought them, it looked like they were 100 years old. They are made out of lotus root. A machine hasn't compressed it and made it, you know. There's somebody who has sat with his hands and spun magic onto this furniture. And it's a piece of little, you know, workmanship in my house. So this is a lovely piece that we've come to love. It was done by Salman, who's an awesome painter. And this is something he gave to Kabir when he directed Bajrangi Bhaijaan. So, you know, even though I give myself a lot more credit for doing up the spaces in this house, the fact is that I can't execute anything till I hear Kabir's voice of approval or disapproval in my voice. So I can't take that credit away from him, speaking of the person.
Hi. Can I join the conversation?
As long as you say
nice things about me.
And it's all done by me and I'm the one.
Yes, I shall say that, though that's not true.
Partially
true.
Okay.
So if she's not sure whether it's yellow or red, then the whole argument with me will make her realize, hey, no, I'm actually on the side of the yellow.
Because he said red. So, you know, it's yin and yang. It's good. We balance.
So sometimes you go orange.
Yeah. When we first came to this house, I must give Kabir due credit where it's due. He did look at it and said, you know, this is the one. And I said, no, this looks like crap. Because it was, you know, I couldn't visualize how it would work. It was just half this flat. The terrace had pipes running all over it. So we went out and we looked at many more flats. But eventually...
Well, yeah, we thought about it and we realized that this, you know, in its whole crookedness and its sort of not planned layout, lies the charm. And we could do. So now what people find very charming are these little...
Oh my God, you've got Santorini seats.
Yeah, seats. But those seats are basically to camouflage pipes running all over the terrace.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that is what we use to our advantage.
This house kind of gives me my own piece of the sky.
I think open terrace is worth its weight in gold. The fact that you can come out and sit and just look up towards the sky is gorgeous.
Brought in a dog into our lives, and then he had his own paraphernalia, and you know, houses don't accommodate for like cupboards for dogs.
This boat here is actually full of blues stuff.
This boat here, I'm going to the airport and I see in a studio there this half boat, and I'm like, oh my God, this is tailor-made to keep my dog stuff. So it's got dog food, dog toys, dog grooming things. It's all hidden. It's beautiful.
Super.
Works well.
I gotta go now. I have to go and meet that person.
You know, only fathers kiss their daughters like this.
On camera.
So I've always been fascinated by how the British have their tea rooms, etc. So I wanted to create this little tea ambience. My dining room has a very informal ambience. People come for tea, they know where everything is kept. It's all a very open scenario. And the thing that I absolutely insisted always on having was an open kitchen, because I don't believe, you know, I love cooking. And I don't believe that it needs to be a room where you hide and you slave over the stove and somebody is sitting outside enjoying all the food. It should be an interactive activity. And again, all rustic, all vintage, all rustic. So this is a bedroom, but it opens into the terrace. So when we have a party, we also open this out. So it also becomes de facto dance floor, come bedroom. So the story is that I saw this Bali platform bed, which I'd never seen before. And I told Kabir, I said, I have to have it. He said, we just bought a master bed, king size. I said, I don't care, I must have it. He looked at it, he said, dekh lena, it's like an item number. You're going to get tired of it very soon. But it's now been what, like 10 years, and it's not an item number, it's the lead heroine. It's right here. So now I'm going to show you what is perhaps the only part of the house that is mine. This is pretty much my happy space. I sit here, I do all my work from here. This is also a great vantage point to spy on the children, okay? Because there's a children's room is right here. So when I sit here, I know what's going on here. So I have two kids. I have a 14-year-old boy and I have a 9-year-old girl. I wanted them to share a room because I think that creates a lot of bonding, but they couldn't agree on what decor to use. So we've split it into two. This is Syrah's half, which is girly. And we've got Vivan's half, which is boy. You know, this is a room in an identity crisis. You know, color says so much about the space you're in at the moment. And different seasons allow you different colors. So this is that one room where, according to season, I don't fear to just pick up a brush and paint over it. You know, I want this house to be the kind of house when somebody comes and spills a Coke, they don't have to feel apologetic or feel weird. This is a house that spills a lot of things and it's okay. You know, we are like four people, five people and a dog. So, you know, it's just, everything is welcome. This is the first time we're doing this, I better tell you, because we don't do stuff like this ever. Her favorite holiday destination is Maldives or Thailand, 100%. Correct.
Correct. Huh. Dash is where Kabir's heart is, you've written behind the camera. Correct.
Mini's pet peeves is things out of place. But this is a very large accusation, huh? Things out of place means...
Like, yeah, like suppose these four are lying here, suppose one is here. Now you're not going to be able to concentrate on this interview. As simple as that, till this comes back.
Okay, fine. Okay,
now we can continue. Kabir's habit that annoys me never unpacks his suitcase. Correct. But I always pack for both.
But when we're coming never back. Unpacks yeah, never for unpacks for either. Yeah. Okay?
I love packing, I hate unpacking.
Mini never lies about anything.
More or less.
Ta-da!
That I know of.
Okay then. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share.
Asian Paints, where the heart is.